I want to welcome everyone tonight to the August 4th Town Council meeting. Thank you for being here. It's going to be a nice meeting. We get to see new employees. We get to see recognition for some of our employees. We've got a great opportunity for additional educational opportunities for Knightdale, which is coming up, and we want to thank you for being here. Russell, the mayor, he is can't be here tonight. He's on a trip with his son. He's out of the country. I think they're playing soccer is what they're doing. So he couldn't fly back in for the meeting. He'll be gone the rest of the week. Could we please bow and have a word of prayer? Dear and Father, thank you this day you've given us to come and the opportunities that we have and that we do what's best for the citizens of Knightdale and be with us and guide us as we make the correct decisions that affect everyone that's involved. Again, thank you for everything you've done for us. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, can I get an adoption? Is everything on the agenda staying there, right? Now. Okay, could I get a motion to adopt the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
Got a motion second. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 No opposed. The July 16th minutes, have y'all had a chance to look at them? If so, could I get a motion to approve the minutes?
I'd like to make a motion to approve the July 16th, 2014 minutes.
Got a motion, need a second?
Second.
Got a second. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Okay, now we go on to the good part. The introduction of our code enforcement officer and planner. Chris, I'm turning it over to you.
Thank you, sir. Good evening, members of the council. This evening, I'm here to introduce to you, very excitedly, our new code enforcement officer and planner, Mr. Matt Christian. He's making his way up right now. Matt comes to us after an internship with the town of Weaverville near Asheville in the western part of the state. He has a master's degree from Appalachian State University, as well as his undergrad is also from Appalachian. He says he likes to play some golf, although he just says, what do you say? He tries at it. That's what he says. But we're really excited to have him on the team. Obviously, our code enforcement position has been vacant for nearly 6 months now, and so we'll be able to catch up on some things that have been lagging. So we welcome him to the team and ask him to just say hi real quick.
Yeah, I'm really excited to be here. I'm ready to get my career started. I've been in school for a long time, and seems like a great community. I'm looking forward to getting to know the area, getting to know the people, and getting to know you guys. So thank you.
Well, welcome. We're glad to have you on our team, and this is a team, you know, that's the way we handle it in town. Appreciate you being here.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Town manager, you've got a special recognition.
I can't let that pass without noticing the growth of the black and gold.
You know. Well, I was going to say something about Mountaineers, but, you know,
balance things
yourself
up a little bit. Joey, will you come on up here, please? We're going to take just a minute to recognize Joanna Gombatz for an achievement we're very proud of her for. She recently gained certification as a certified budget and evaluation officer. It took a minimum number of years of experience and education to even get into the class. And then once you get in, it takes a good while to complete it. You have to take courses in budgeting and capital finance, performance measurement, program evaluation, and a number of areas. So it's no light accomplishment. And she's had this for a little while because it was presented a couple weeks ago by the actual association, but I want to read it here. This is to certify that Joanna Gombatz has achieved a commendable level of expertise needed to perform the duties of budget and evaluation officer under the provisions of the certification program of the North Carolina Local Government Budget Association, and having complied with the prescribed requirements is hereby designated as a certified budget and evaluation officer, February 28th, 2014. So please help me in congratulating Joanna.
See, Matt, we got great employees here. Okay, turn it over to our fire chief.
Good evening.
As you, some of you are aware, and some of you are new to the council, a couple years ago we got a grant from FEMA for volunteer recruitment and retention. And as part of the grant, we also received funding to be able to give some scholarships to our explorers. Our explorer post is actually through the Boy Scouts of America, and we sponsor it. And the explorer post or idea is that you bring young people in and you show them what a particular profession is like and see if that's a career that they would like to choose. And we've had huge success with this program. We've had a lot of young people who have come through and they are now working as law enforcement officers or firefighters or EMTs. And so for 2014, I've got three folks. One wasn't able to be here tonight, but I do have two with us tonight that I'd like to award this FEMA Explorer Scholarship grant to. So Evan, Brianna, if y'all come up. Evan started with us when he was 14 years old as an explorer. He's served as a captain on the explorer post. He graduated from Clayton High School, and his plans is to, he's actually going to Johnson Community College this fall and wants to transfer to NC State to major in agriculture. And he's been a tremendous asset to our post and has brought a lot of skills to that, and we'll also be benefiting from it because he will be volunteering with us as a volunteer firefighter now that he's 18.
Excellent.
So, Evan?
Thank you.
Brianna hasn't been with us for 4 years like Evan has, but the time that she was here, she has been tremendous. She is a go-getter. Whatever she does, she puts her whole self into it. And that's shown. She's a graduate of Knightdale High School. I think she played every sport there, including she wrestled. She was in National Honor Society and a host of other things. And Brianna plans on going to UNCG and going to law school from there. But she shared with me also that they have a fire science type program there also that she wants to do during the summer and all, because we piqued her interest, and she wants to continue to do that. So, Brianna. Last young man that wasn't able to be here tonight was Ben Watkins. Ben started out with us when he was 14 also, like Evan did. And Ben, back a couple years ago, got in a really serious accident south of town here. And he was in the hospital for probably 3 or 4 months. And I mean, he was in ICU and that kind of thing. He's a fighter. He's came back from that. And he is pursuing his dream of being a career firefighter. He's enrolled in the JC program for fire protection technology, their 2-year degree there. And also he is turned 18 and he's volunteering with Eastern Wake Fire Department, which, you know, we run a lot of calls with them, and so we'll have some benefit from the training and the things that we've taught him. So we've got a good group of explorers and continue to hope to do that.
Good. Glad to hear it. At this time, we want to open it up to the public for anything that is not on tonight's agenda. Come up, state your name, your address, and say what you want to say.
Good evening. Adam Prince, 1401 Kingman Drive. I live in the Churchill subdivision. What I'd like to talk about tonight is the recent decision that the board had in regards to Linwood Road restriping. First of all, with the greenway opening today, my wife, my son, and I are very excited about the greenway. We were on it twice this weekend. We were on it Sunday. We did 6 miles on it running, and some friends and I ran biked on it on Saturday morning to connect to the Neuse River Trail, and we saw at least 40 different people over the 2 days on it. So it's great for Knightdale, and when you throw in the greenway, the Smithfield Road sidewalk improvements, the Rex Endowment grants, we are really building a very comprehensive connectivity system throughout the town. And I do understand that this takes time to build and come to fruition, but it's very exciting to see. However, with that being said, I was very disappointed to see on the recent decision to nix the Linwood Road restriping plan, and I see this as a step backwards onto the overall connectivity plan for our town. And I see it on three different ways. The first part is connection to the rest of the system. Hinton Oaks Road on the north side of Knightdale Boulevard beyond Kohl's is already currently striped for bike lanes, including plans to when that road gets extended, that is going to have additional bike lanes done to it, and it's also for Hodge Road. The striping of Linwood would extend that connectivity from the north side of Knightdale Boulevard to the residential side on the south side. In addition, connectivity to the shopping centers with the Lowe's Foods, the grocery stores, the banks, the entire shopping center on both sides of Knightdale Boulevard, the bike lanes will allow dedicated access to those shopping centers. And finally, also for the recreation and fitness enthusiasts of all levels, myself, my wife, my neighbors, everyone included. And you have people are accessing it throughout from Planner's Walk itself. There's a number of people that I know that live in Planner's Walk and from the surrounding subdivisions that do not have direct access that uses Linwood Road access. Yesterday we saw two different families come down the Linwood Road access to the Greenway. But also the Rex Wellness Center, which I am a member of, in which we have a number of classes that actually go outside for running or biking training, including the triathlon training, that would be able to use the bike lane as a dedicated lane for their training and connectivity to the bike trail. And also for regular, it doesn't have to be tied to the neighborhood or the wellness center, but regular biking enthusiasts who are out there just training, that ride, a number of times I've driven down Linwood Road and have seen bikes along the road. This would give additional dedicated lanes for them to travel on. And also, because of the connection at Linwood Road, it can take some bikes off of Linwood at Hodge because it would provide a connection to the trail where there's no traffic competing against it from Linwood all the way down to the Hodge Road intersection. I ask that the town council and the board to consider this decision and allow all residents of Knightdale, not just those of Planner's Walk, to voice their opinions on this matter, as this I see as a great step forward for Knightdale if we can re-include the bike lane restriping. Thank you.
Okay, anyone have any questions? Appreciate it. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Dan Caswell, 2130 Old Rosebud Drive. I'm on the board of directors at the Churchill HOA. And I'll keep it short and sweet. I'm here for the same reason that Adam is. He put it very well, named a lot of good reasons why it's important. To add a couple, I know that we just recently had a branding effort that went on. We spent some time and money to put that together, and I think it turned out great. I think one of the things that we did here out of that committee, out of that process, was that people are really happy about the Greenway and the progress it was making, alternate transportation methods. And at the end of the day, I think that the decision whether or not we were going to have more traffic, more cycle traffic on that road, was made when we put that Greenway trailhead in. So at this point, I think the decision is whether we want to go further to make it safe to have those cyclists on that road. So again, I think we'd ask that everyone get input and that the decision be rethought. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Shannon Bryan, 2503 Ferdinand, also in the Churchill subdivision. I am also a realtor and I love selling Knightdale. One of the main things we talk about is the affordability of the housing here, access to downtown, and the greenway system, and we're really limiting the safety of our residents by not putting those bike paths in. There's a neighborhood going up on Hodge. They are gonna utilize that road to get to the grocery store. They're not gonna go to the highway. So we're already gonna have traffic there regardless of whether we have bikes there or not, which I think was one of the main arguments that the Planner's Walk group made. It's really about keeping the people that are gonna use that access safe. I mean, I know we all wanna keep this community safe. I would just rather see that striping put in now before somebody gets hurt. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
My name is Holly Atkins. I live at 4601 Smarty Jones Drive. I do live in Churchill. I am approaching this actually from a kid safety standpoint. I have two children, 14 and 7. They both ride bikes. They both do it safely and without any indication that there are bike lanes. The chances of them getting hit are very high. I think that a lot of opponents of the bike lanes were more concerned about the fact that their property values were in jeopardy. I feel that even though the signs posted say speed limit 25, if there are no bike lanes, those children are going to get hurt because nobody drives 25 miles an hour on Linwood. It has direct access to the shopping centers, as Adam pointed out, and I think that allowing my child to go at the age of 14 to the store to grab a soda or grab a bag of chips in a safe way is a lot more important than worrying about whether or not someone else should be able to park on a street when there's just not enough people represented that opposed the action in the first place. So I really feel like this should be revisited and possibly put to the public in terms of what they wanted and not just a small minority of the entire population. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else that would like to speak? On this item or any other item that's not on tonight's agenda? We will take a look at it. The striping's not done yet, right?
No.
We will take a look at it and see what we can do. I'm not going to promise you anything, be honest with you. That's for sure. But you know, the people that came, the president of the Homeowners Association, which, you know, you are, they're representing their homeowners just like anybody else. And that's who I listen to. I listen to the President of the Homeowners Association because he represents their homes. You know, you had a lot of people that came to the meeting over at Planner's Walk that night, even bicyclists, said they didn't like it. They didn't like the way it was designed because of the way the bike lanes are and the cars turning in. You had 9 different intersections that were, where the bike lanes goes out, the intersection comes in, you have bicycles and cars, you know, like that. But what we'll do, we'll go back and look at, you know, the what the engineer and stuff like that, and our engineer, town engineer, and see what we can come up with. Maybe we can come up with something a little different. I'll have to give Mark a little credit when they were talking about him and Russell. They were talking about a center lane, you know, stripe down the center lane, but no posted actual bike lanes, which would narrow the road and slow traffic down the way the engineers say it would. We'll look at it. Like I said, I'm not going to promise you anything because I voted to keep it like it was because I listened to the Homeowners Association president and the board they had there that night, and that's the reason I voted that way. So, but I have no problem looking at it before we do striping. No problem whatsoever. Okay. Anyone else have anything they'd like to, that's not on tonight's agenda? Anyone have a comment on this item? Okay. All right, let's move on. We've got a consent agenda. Can I get a motion to adopt? Thank you all for coming. Appreciate it. Thank you. Got a consent agenda. Need a motion to adopt the consent agenda?
I'd like to make a motion to adopt the consent agenda.
Got a motion, need a second?
Second.
Okay, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 All those opposed, none. Okay. We have no public hearings for tonight. Mr. Town Attorney, do you have anything for us?
Nothing tonight, sir.
Well, I appreciate it. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Let's go to old business, which is Thales Academy, an additional educational opportunity for the people of Knightdale.
Good evening, Mayor Pro Tem and members of council. I hope you're all doing well tonight. Before you tonight is Zoning Map Amendment 314 Thales Academy. As we mentioned, Withers and Ravenel is the applicant, the current property owner is Knightdale Investors LLC, and the developer is Thales Academy. They're proposing about a 32,000 square foot, two-story elementary school on about 4.56 acres. The current zoning is UR12 in the proposing urban residential conditional district as the zoning map amendment request. In this zoning district for a elementary school, a conditional district zoning is required. The existing conditions, currently it's undeveloped and part of a larger Knightdale Station subdivision. The location, it'll be located off what's the proposed Collector Road B. It's located across the street from the YMCA facility in the Knightdale Station subdivision. As I mentioned, it's a required conditional district, and therefore, as required conditional district, if there are certain aspects of the Unified Development Ordinance that cannot be met, they can provide alternatives showing how they can meet the spirit and intent. This is the overall site plan showing the proposed layout. They have provided a circulation drive located in front of the building, which ranges from 36 feet in this general location of the driveway to about 80 feet if you measure from here to here. Again, it's 32,000 square feet and two stories. Located adjacent to a BMP that's associated with R1 and R2, which are currently under construction for the single family lots. There's also a proposed BMP here and their BMP for their site located to the north. The requested UDO exceptions are that the circulation drive in the front yard be larger than 10 feet in width. As I mentioned, it ranges from 36 feet to 80 feet. It is being proposed in that width for queuing, for drop-off and pickup, and special events when they have award ceremonies for additional parking if necessary. Also, the fence, one, they're proposing a black vinyl chain link coated fence. Our ordinance would normally require a wrought iron or aluminum looking wrought iron fence. They're also proposing 6 feet in the front yard, whereas our ordinance would only typically permit 4 feet. This item was discussed in addition to the others at our technical review committee meeting in June, and it was determined by TRC that the consistency of a 6 foot fence would probably have a better aesthetic than jogging from 4 feet to 6 feet. And also that the landscaping be provided on the exterior of the fence so that when somebody looking in, they see the landscaping as opposed to the fence. The other item they're asking for an exception to is that the rear building roofline will not have a building or wall offset every 50 feet. Our UDO currently requires that if you have a roof that's more than 50 feet in length, you have a roof or building wall offset. These are the proposed elevations. This is the front elevation that will face Collector Road B. After TRC, they did add this peaked element on the side, similar to what is currently shown on the front elevation to break up that side elevation. And this is the rear elevation. This is the landscape plan. So they are proposing to locate the landscaping on the outside of the fence. So if you're walking on the greenway that's proposed in this location, you will see the landscaping as opposed to the fence. It is located within the neighborhood design district. And there's several objectives it could further, such as promoting the vibrant, sustainable, and safe community in which people desire to live, work, and visit, promote a system of coordinated land uses, providing pedestrian scale of design through the development of sidewalks, where permitted civic, professional, and retail uses, she could be constructed at pedestrian scale and designed to accommodate all modes of transportation. Within Knightdale Station subdivision, there is a bus stop proposed. Civic, institutional, and commercial activities should be concentrated in neighborhood villages that are within walking distance of most residences within the neighborhood design district. Schools should be constructed as multi-story architectural centerpieces of the community and located to promote the option of facilities and children walking or cycling to school. It's adjacent to a greenway as well as located centrally. And all neighborhood villages should contain mixed uses horizontally or vertically. During the public hearing at town council, no one spoke. The Land Use Review Board did vote unanimously to approve the zoning map amendment with the three UDO exceptions and clarification of the driveway width or circulation drive width within the front yard. And this is their written advisory statement from the LURB that they proposed to town council. In accordance with General Statute 168.383, prior to adopting any or rejecting any zoning amendment, the governing board shall adopt a statement describing the consistency with a comprehensive plan. The proposed statement of consistency and reasonableness of action that staff has proposed is the proposed zoning map amendment advances the stated objectives of promoting a vibrant, sustainable, and safe community design in which people desire to live, work, and visit, and providing a system of coordinated land uses that encourage decision makers, the development community, and town staff to view each new development proposal in a larger and regional context. It is furthermore consistent with the comprehensive plan's stated goals of civic, institutional, and commercial activities concentrated in the neighborhood villages and including mixed uses in neighborhood villages. Staff's recommendation would be to adopt the statement of plan consistency and reasonableness of action, approve ZMA 314 and ordinance 140804-002, subject to the following condition, which is to for the applicant to submit construction drawings in accordance with the conditions noted at the technical review committee meeting and any other items that town council may mention here. And we're available to answer any questions you may have.
Does anyone have any questions of the staff? Okay. Would anyone from the academy like to speak? Everything good?
Hello, my name's Michael Roach. I'm with Thales Academy. If you want my address, I'm in Youngsville. But we're looking forward to coming to Knightdale. We put a lot of work into getting this school together. We have schools in other locations, Wake Forest and Apex and Raleigh, which are all doing well. We're really looking forward to Knightdale. It's definitely a different community than those other communities, and being in a subdivision like that, I think it'll be very interesting to see the families come out and be able to participate. We are growing right now and in our current locations, and we feel Knightdale's going to be a great asset to us to grow. We are also looking at putting in a high school in Knightdale as we grow into it, and really look forward to doing that. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to ask.
Anybody have any questions?
No, I think we're looking forward to it.
Yeah, I want to mention, you know, it's a really nice looking, impressive building. I was wondering, are they all like that?
Yeah, we have two main buildings, our K5 and then our 612. The K5 is, all three of them are very similar. Basically, we took our first design, and each time we try and tweak it, really the only tweaks we're making for this one outside of what we normally do is on the outside with the sides that we added to meet the UDO, and we had some minor changes inside. Just we found one classroom, which was a computer room, that we could make just a hair bigger, so we've kind of realigned a little bit right in front, but it's actually working very well. We We did look at what kind of changes we should make, and we talked to all of our headmasters, and they feel it's a very efficient use of space. The children can be moved around very easily, so we tend not to change if we don't have to.
Have you always used chain link on all your others?
Generally 8 foot with barbed wire on top.
At all, okay.
So this, yeah, that is a little change going down to 6 foot. But it, you really don't notice it. You, if you go to our other campuses, you won't even see it. It's generally hidden back in the landscape, and it's a big concern for our parents. They safety is one of their main concerns going to a private school.
That's what the TRC looked at it a lot about. That's the reason the way it was designed was the fence was on the outside, the landscaping was on the inside, and we felt like it would be better served if the was reversed.
Sure.
So that the plant material would hide the fence, sort of. It would kind of grow into it. You wouldn't be able to see it after so many years. And the one over, I rode by and looked at the one on Fox Road, and pretty much going to be the same as design as, yep, this one. And it's kind of laid out somewhat like that. And I'll tell you what, it just, if you go over there in the mornings, I mean, it flows so smooth, you know, in and out. It's just, it's amazing to me. And the cars you have going through there. And I like the way, you know, you've come up with the design to go on through, and everything's internal. So
yeah,
that helps all the other streets.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure do.
Any other questions?
Any other questions? Thank you.
Thank you very much. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Does anyone else have any more questions of staff or any? Is anyone from the public would like to speak on this matter? Seeing none, we turn it over to the council to get a motion.
I'd like to make a motion to adopt a statement of plan consistency and reasonableness of action, approve ZMA 3-14 and adopt ordinance 14-08-04-002.
Okay, we have a motion. Could I get a second?
Second.
Got a motion and a second. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, which is none. We're glad to have you in Knightdale. We're looking forward to the educational opportunities that our kids can have in Knightdale. Thank you. There's no new business. We're moving right along. Any other business that we have? None. Committee reports.
Public safety did not meet this evening.
Oh, good.
Well, it got quiet in here. No one said anything.
I know. All right, we're rolling right along. There's no committee reports. No need to go into closed session this evening. We have hit the end of a council meeting. Could I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Got a second?
Second.
Got a second? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
All right. We are adjourned. Oh.
I think the record should show how smoothly the meeting went tonight. Under your guidance.